Picture this. You're strapped into the cockpit of one of the most iconic fighters ever built. Your hands gripping the side stick as you light the afterburner and feel 29,000 pounds of thrust slam you back into your seat. This is the F-16 Fighting Falcon, better known as the Viper. And today, I'm diving deep into Eagle Dynamics' simulation of this legendary bird. Now, before we get started, let me be clear about something. This isn't going to be your typical, here's how to start the engine guide. I'm going to talk about what makes this module tick, why it's been such a phenomenon in the DCS community, and whether it's worth your hard-earned cash. So buckle up, because we are about to take this digital Viper for one hell of a ride. The F-16C Viper dropped into DCS world back in October 2019. And let me tell you, it caused quite a stir. Here was Eagle Dynamics, primarily known for their study-level aircraft modules, suddenly announcing they were taking one of the most requested aircraft in the flight sim community. And honestly, a lot of us were skeptical, including myself. The F-16 has been the bread and butter of combat flight simulation for decades, from the original Falcon series to Falcon BMS. This aircraft has been simulated to death. So the question wasn't whether Eagle Dynamics could make an F-16, but whether they could make one that stood out in an already crowded field. Fast forward to today, and I can tell you that after spending quite a lot of hours in this digital cockpit, they've managed to create something pretty special. But like any relationship, it's complicated. Let's start with what we are actually flying here. The DCS F-16C represents a Block 50 variant, which puts in roughly in the late 1990s to early 2000s time frame. This isn't the latest and greatest F-16B with all the modern bells and whistles, but it's not exactly ancient history either. What you're getting is a single-seat, single-engine, multirole fighter that's been the backbone of air forces around the world for over four decades. More than 4,600 of these birds have rolled off the production line, serving with 26 different countries. That's not just impressive. That's practically unprecedented in aviation history. The real magic of the F-16 isn't just in its numbers, though. This aircraft was revolutionary when it first flew in 1974. Because it was the first production fighter designed to be inherently unstable. Yeah, you heard it right. The engineers at General Dynamics basically said, let's build a fighter that wants to fall out of the sky, and then handed the job of keeping it airborne to a computer. This relaxed static stability, combined with the fly-by-wire flight control system, gives the Viper its legendary agility. We are talking about an aircraft that can pull 9Gs all day long, while maintaining control authority that would make other fighters jealous. It's like having a sports car that also happens to carry air-to-air missiles. Speaking of that agility, let's talk about how this thing actually flies in DCS. Eagle Dynamics has done their homework here, and it shows. The moment you lift off the runway, you can feel that this isn't your grandfather's Cessna. The F-16 wants to fly, and it wants to fly fast. The flight model captures that characteristic F-16 responsiveness beautifully. Small stick inputs translate into immediate aircraft response, but it's not twitchy or unpredictable. There's a linear relationship between what you're asking for and what the aircraft delivers, which is exactly what you want in a fighter. Now, here's where things get interesting. Because the F-16 is inherently unstable, the flight control computer is constantly making tiny adjustments to keep you in the air. In DCS, this translates to an aircraft that feels alive under your hands. You're not just along the ride, you're dancing with the airplane. If you have flown other DCS modules, you will immediately notice the difference. The A-10C feels like a flying tank, solid and purposeful. The FA-18C feels sophisticated and refined. The F-16C feels like a thoroughbred racehorse that's been fed on nothing but rocket fuel and attitude. Performance-wise, the numbers speak for themselves. With the F-110 GE-129 engine pushing out 29,000 pounds of thrust, this thing will accelerate from 0 to Mach 1.2 faster than you can say Fox 2. The sustained turn rate is absolutely bonkers, and the instantaneous turn capability will have you pulling G's that would make a roller coaster jealous. Now, let's get into the meat and potatoes of what makes this module special. The systems. The F-16C in DCS comes with a fully realized avionics suite that's both comprehensive and thankfully relatively user-friendly compared to some of other study-level modules in DCS. The heart of the F-16C avionics is the AN-APG-68 radar, and Eagle Dynamics has modeled this system in impressive detail. This is a mechanically scanned array radar that might not have the raw capability of the newer ASAR systems, but it's reliable, proven, and more than capable of handling both air-to-air and air-to-ground missions. In air-to-air mode, this radar will track multiple targets simultaneously and provide you with all the information you need to handle threats effectively. The interface is intuitive once you get the hang of it, and the symbology is clear and informative. You're not going to be squinting at cryptic displays wondering what the hell you're looking at. For air-to-ground work, the radar transforms into a powerful mapping and targeting system. The synthetic aperture radar modes provide detailed ground mapping capability, while the ground moving target indicator can pick up vehicles and other moving targets from the background clutter. It's like having X-ray vision for the battlefield. The multifunction displays are where you'll spend most of your time when you're not looking outside, and they are beautifully implemented. The pages are logically organized, the symbology is clear, and the system responds too quickly to inputs. You've got dedicated pages for radar, navigation, stores management, and defensive systems, and more. And speaking of inputs, the HOTAS implementation is absolutely stellar. The hands-on throttle and stick philosophy means you can operate most of the aircraft system without taking your hands off the primary flight controls. Once you run the button layout, you'll be switching between air-to-air, air-to-ground modes, cycling through radar settings, and managing countermeasures without ever looking down at the cockpit. Let's talk about the fun stuff, the armaments. The F-16C comes loaded for bear with an impressive array of both air-to-air and air-to-ground ordnance that'll handle just about any mission you can throw at it. For air-to-air work, you've got the classic combination of AIM-9 sidewinders for closing dogfights, and AIM-120 AMRAAMs for beyond visual range engagements. The sidewinders come in several variants, including the impressive AIM-9X with its off-foresight capability. The AMRAAMs are your bread-and-butter BBR missiles, and the F-16's radar and fire control system make employing them a joy. And let's not forget about the M61A1 Vulcan cannon. This six-barreled beast fires 20mm rounds at up to 6,000 rounds per minute. When you squeeze that trigger, you're firing a stream of destruction that sounds absolutely incredible. For ground pounding, you've got everything from general purpose bombs to precision guided munitions like GBU-12 Paveway 2 and the fearsome AGM-88 HOM anti-radiation missile. The targeting pod integration is particularly well done, providing crisp sensor imagery and accurate crosshair correlation between the pod and the HUD. Now, let's talk about the learning curve. If you're coming from a simpler aircraft or arcade-style flight games, the F-16C is going to feel like drinking from a fire hose. This is a complex, systems-heavy aircraft that demands respect and patience. But here's the thing, it's not as intimidating as it might seem at first glance. The F-16 was designed to be flown by 20-something fighter pilots, not rocket scientists. The systems are logical, the procedures are standardized, and once you start to understand the underlying philosophy, everything begins to make sense. My advice? Start with the basics. Learn to start the engine, taxi, takeoff, and land. Get comfortable with the flight model and the basic systems. Then gradually work your way up to the more complex operations. The DCS community is fantastic when it comes to helping newcomers, with tons of tutorials and helpful folks willing to share their knowledge. Now, before we get too carried away singing the F-16's praises, let's talk about the reality of this early access module. Because yeah, while it's come a long way, there are still some things you should know about. You're essentially paying to be a beta tester. Though Eagle Dynamics has made significant progress in addressing many long-standing issues, major problems that plagued the earlier versions, like rearming crashes and radar tracking glitches where targets would teleport around your display, have been largely resolved through recent updates. That said, the early access nature means new patches can sometimes introduce unexpected behaviors or undocumented changes that leave you scratching your head. Some targeting pod correlation issues may still occasionally surface, and there can be quirks that pop up in multiplayer environments when systems interact in complex ways. The good news is that Eagle Dynamics continues to be responsive to community feedbacks and bug reports. The module is significantly more stable and polished than it was at launch, but it's worth understanding what you're getting into. This isn't a shrink-wrapped final product. It's an evolving simulation that's steadily improving. We need to briefly address the elephant in the room, the Falcon BMS. This free, community-driven overhaul of classic Falcon 4.0 offers different systems modeling and an unmatched dynamic campaign system where your actions have real strategic consequences. BMS excels in electronic warfare, data link functionality, and overall sensor fusion, areas where it's arguably more complete than DCS. Although its graphics engine has been updated, it shows its age visually, as it's built on a 1998 foundation. The choice comes down to priorities. DCS offers beautiful graphics, modern production values, and ease of use. BMS provides unmatched systems depth and campaign complexity with dated visuals. The reality is that many serious F-16 enthusiasts end up running both simulations, treating them as complementary, rather than competing experiences. Each offers something the other can't match, and that's perfectly fine. So after all that, what's the verdict? Is the DCS F-16C Viper worth your money? If you're looking for versatile, well-implemented, and thoroughly engaging combat aircraft simulation, then absolutely. The F-16C hits that sweet spot between complexity and accessibility that makes it appealing to both newcomers and experienced simmers. Is it perfect? Heck no. There are still bugs to squash, features to implement, and the occasional patch that makes you question the QA process. But Eagle Dynamics has been consistently updating and improving the module, and the core experience is solid. Compared to other modules in DCS, the F-16C offers excellent value. You're getting a fully realized combat aircraft with comprehensive systems modeling, excellent flight dynamics, and a wide variety of mission capabilities. Whether you want to be a dog fighter, a mud mover, or a jack of all trades, the Viper has you covered. My personal take? If you're even remotely interested in modern combat aviation, the F-16C should be on your shortlist. It's challenging enough to keep you engaged for hundreds of hours, but approachable enough that you won't want to throw your computer out the window. Just go in with realistic expectations about the early access nature of the product. The F-16 Fighting Falcon has been called many things over the years. The fighter pilot's fighter. The world's most successful material aircraft. The backbone of NATO air power. In DCS world, Eagle Dynamics has captured the essence of what makes this aircraft special. It's not just about the systems, or the flight model, or the weapons, though all of those are excellent. It's about the total package, the feeling of being strapped into one of the most capable fighters ever built, and knowing that you have the tools to handle whatever the virtual battlefield throws at you. So there you have it, my take on the DCS F-16C Viper. If you found this review helpful, let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more DCS content. Until next time, fly safe, and I'll see you in the skies.